And a good morning to you. Great to have you here with us on Sun News Network. And my thanks to Ryan Doyle, who filled in for me while my head seems to heal from a bad cold. So good morning to you. Good to have you with us. Let's start things off. While stumping in Brandon, Manitoba, once again, Justin Trudeau talked about the issue of minimum mandatories. But again, he came up short with details. So let's bring in Zach Pagan and Marco Glassman. Of course, you're a Liberal pundit. You're a contributor here at Sun News Network. Let's get you guys started off. Why will he not give detail? What's the point in saying anything at all?
Well, listen, as I explained very clearly last week, the way that our system works in Canada is that leaders are chosen for political parties very early on, and they reveal policies over the course of several years leading up to an election when a full platform is released. What we do know is that mandatory minimums don't work, and that our crime level
right now is...
Well, we have a series of evidence that shows that they don't work, and since 1972 we've got the lowest...
But give me a tangible example of where it hasn't worked.
For example, in Texas, where we have
Canada. We're not talking about the United States. Like, put it to you this way. We're in Canada. We're not that tough here on crime. Compared to other countries.
Let me just say, Alex, I think what's most concerning about this is just floating the idea that he wants to have a relook or whatever word he used on mandatory minimums. I think the concern is the Liberal critic actually basically said, well, with all mandatory minimums would be on the table. We're going to have to look at all of them. And that concerns me because, you know, we have important issues like mandatory minimums for child trafficking, for example, which I might add Justin Trudeau voted for at one point. So I think that these are now, I want to know, you know, is he going to support that? Does he want to get rid of mandatory minimums for serious criminals who have done serious things? And I would love to know.
Let's just stop and see what he said while stumping yesterday in Brandon, Manitoba. So let's play that and we'll go off with the clip.
We need to reduce crime. We need to reduce the amount of victims of crime. And in order to do that, we have to be smart about our approach on that. And what we've seen a number of times is that the conservative approach on imposing mandatory minimums on anything and hoping that that will solve the problem hasn't solved the problem nearly enough. And we just need to be a lot smarter in our approach on crime, to give less crime.
Mm-hmm. Pretty ambiguous.
Here's the problem, is that tough on crime is viewed by the conservatives generally as being a slogan and not something in reality. As Justin just said right there, it's important to be smart on crime. So if tough on crime means what this current conservative government has done, imposing a mandatory minimum of 2 years on young kids for exchanging, you know, small amounts of marijuana in front of a school, then no, I'm not tough on crime, I'm smart on crime. But if you want to be seriously tough on crime and to talk about rehabilitation rather than simply punishment, and as what happened in Texas and many other jurisdictions where you're throwing more and more people in jail, only to throw more and more people in jail than those. In that case, I'm not tough on crime.
Zach, why does it always have to come back for marijuana legalization? I guess this is news to the Liberal Party, but there's more bigger issues in Canada than a bunch of friends hanging out and smoking pot. The reality is Justin Trudeau, and apparently he seems to love the idea of talking about marijuana legalization. I mean, just yesterday in Brandon, he when asked him a question, he answered in favor of marijuana legalization in front of Aboriginal students.
That's
the report that I'm hearing, and I think that's just absurd. Well, I mean, there's way more important issues to be dealing with here. We're talking about mandatory minimums across the board, or that's what the Liberal critic has said. And these are, so you could be talking about mandatory minimums for very serious crimes. I've already mentioned child trafficking, sex offenders, and so forth. I think it's very important to send a strong message and not have these criminals coming back on the streets with high recidivism rates.
But it was Liberals themselves under Crutchett who wanted mandatory. They set them out in Bill 68.
There were a series of mandatory minimums that were imposed in the past. Yes, by Liberal governments. Justin Trudeau does not speak for previous Liberal governments.
Apparently.
I think a few of them might
have issues with what he's going out and saying, because I don't get the sense that when he sends out his little tweets when he's sitting in his living room all cozy by the fire, does he give this some thought as real policy,
Listen,
or is he just throwing this out as a taster?
The Liberal Party has committed to become the most open political party in the history of Canada, and that means that we can have open disagreements, and I'm sure that he is going to listen to a wide variety of different people from the grassroots and to talk about whether we should have mandatory minimums at all, whether we should have some. My personal opinion, and I don't speak for the party, is that I personally trust judges who know these issues far better to impose the appropriate sentencing, etc., more so than the trained SEALs who are forced to vote on this legislation in the Harper backbench. So that's simply my opinion. I'm sure that Justin will hear many different opinions and will come up with the appropriate policy based on Democratic consensus before the election in 2015.
So let me just ask a question then. I think the issue here is there's a lot of things that Justin says, and he kind of throws out ideas. We've seen him muse or posit about certain things, and then when he's actually challenged on it, he backtracks. We have the same issue with carbon pricing. He says he muses about setting a price on carbon. We don't know how he's going to do that, but then asked about it, he kind of backtracks. I find the big issue here is you can't just muse about something and then not have a specific policy to back it up, and I think that's a big problem. It's a question about judgment. You need to ask him, well, you've mentioned mandatory minimums. What are you going to do? Which one? I really want to know this. This is an important question to Canadians.
I think it's one of the most important questions to Canadians when you talk about crime, because a lot of people, as I first mentioned, think our country is too soft on crime already, so why would we make
it
easier?
We need to talk about soft on crime and tough on crime. These are slogans. We need to be talking about real things, and maybe Marco and I have a little bit of a disagreement that is somewhat fundamental here. You think that it's important for leaders to place a stake very clearly in the ground
when
and to say this is where I stand completely.
When it comes
whereas
to crime,
I believe
when
it's
it
better
comes
to have a conversation
I'm sorry,
on policy.
I'm sorry, but when it comes to issues such as child trafficking and sex offenders, I think it's important to take a stand and say, yes, I'm in support
absolutely.
Of mandatory minimums.
Yeah.
And I think that Justin Trudeau should say that.
But, you know, this has been a week where we've heard a lot about Justin Trudeau and his policy and his thoughts. Look, he had huge gaffe, I think, is the kind way of saying it, with his comments about China and the administration. And when we gave him the chance to backtrack, he did not backtrack.
I think that the jury's still out on that one. I think that it's really too bad that the media are focusing so much on small comments related to what Justin Trudeau thinks about China.
Well, it's not a small comment to say you admire the administration of
reality,
China.
Well, I think we need to be asking some more fundamental questions here. I mean, what we need to understand is the geopolitics and our interests going forward for Canada dictate that we need to have closer relations with China, unquestionably. So the media should be leading
the
conversation.
There's one thing to have a business relationship with a country.
It's more than just a business relationship. It's a series of strategic relationships. It goes far beyond anything else. There are a series of deep questions that we should be asking. Like, for example, the United States is pivoting fully strategically and militarily towards Asia. How can we begin a conversation in which we can play a role in that?
I really have a big problem with you belittling the massive human rights abuses that have happened in China. I think that Justin Trudeau, he was asked a question specifically about governance.
He was asked a vetted question that he had time to think about.
Well, he had time to think about it, and it is a question about how is the first administration that you think of to set a good example, China. And when you've had massive human rights abuses, you've had forced abortions in China. We've seen millions of people killed, tortured, so forth. The student right uprising in Tiananmen Square. All of these issues, and he actually doubled down on his comments. When he was asked to clarify, he doubled down. So he wasn't joking, he was being quite serious when he was saying. And I think, let's also add that Justin's father, Pierre Elliott Trudeau, when he went to China, during the Cultural Revolution, he said, he basically wrote glowing reviews about the Chinese government and Mao Zedong instead of while there was a planned starvation happening and the people and terrible things happening to the people. I think it's disgusting that he did that.
So is this a gaffe? I'm going to wrap you there. I'm going to turn this thing over to Gina, because online a lot of people are looking at this as a gaffe. It's certainly not getting ignored, Zach.
Certainly. I mean, they've been following certainly every single comment that he's made. It seems like he keeps messing up. He keeps making these gaffes. So Sun News Network has summed them all up for everybody and put them into one article for you to check out. It's called The Top 10 Dumb Trudeau Statements. We know no one else is going to report it like this, so we've decided to put it on our Facebook page. And it got picked up by Yahoo, actually, and they mentioned it. So certainly it's gone pretty far. Let me just take you through some of them. So this is in the past few years. Number 10. Trudeau gets confused defending himself when he calls decibel a decimal. Number 9,
math is hard.
The time when he called then Environment Minister Peter Kent a piece of SHIT, in the House of Commons, by the way. When he had confused and conflicting statements on the gun registry. This happened when he first said he supported the gun registry, then followed quickly by a statement saying he supports Quebec's efforts to bring it back in their province. Number 7, when he was asked a tough question by the CBC about the Taliban, he automatically assumed it was Sun News and a scrum. Well, it was the CBC after all, to our surprise. Number 6, Trudeau blitzed with wrong pot numbers. Yes, this happened. He said the current marijuana laws have left 475,000 people with criminal records. Well, he actually got that fact wrong. Statistics Canada reports total number of incidents is just under 480,000, so he messed up those numbers.
Don't let facts get in the way of a good story.
Oh, man. Number 5, he admires China's basic dictatorship the most. Of course, he said this at a recent ladies' night. Number 4, honor killing and female circumcision, not barbaric. This comment made... in March 2011 when he said he was indeed offended by the word barbaric when referencing honor killings. He called the Boston bombers misunderstood.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that one.
Number two, Trudeau, a conditional Canadian. This one regarding his pro-separatism comments. And number one, Canada belongs to Quebec, but there's problems with Albertans. In other words, he said, Canada isn't doing well right now because it's Albertans who control our community and socio-democratic agenda. That was in November 2010. So those are all our summed up Trudeau statements for you.
So we've got a little foot in mouth. No, we're just debate. We could debate his gaffes, but just be reassured he'll have more.
The reason why I said